Chapter 58. Encouraged, Jiang Ziya cast up his staff for beating gods and struck Liu Ye a heavy blow, bringing him down from his camel. Liu Ye was severely wounded and fled back to his camp on the dust. Zheng Leng panicked when he saw that Liu Ye had been defeated. Neja seized the chance and stabbed him in the shoulder, nearly bringing him down from his beast. He fled back inside the camp gate. Jiang Ziya and his generals returned to the city. Su Hu and his son were delighted to see both Liu Ye and Zheng Leng wounded. Liu Ye sat down in the central camp, seriously hurt by Jiang Ziya's magic staff. When his disciples consoled him over his defeat, he replied unconcernedly, "It doesn't matter. I have my own way of dealing with them." Liu Ye took out some pills of elixir from his gourd, swallowed them, and said with a smile, "Jiang Ziya, though you've won today, just see if you can escape from the calamity ahead." Liu Ye then cured Zheng Leng with his medicine. At the first watch that night, he ordered his four disciples, each carrying a gourd full of plague pills, to secretly enter the city with him on the five elements. They went all over the city, scattering the plague pills into the rivers, streams, creeks, ponds, and wells. They did not return to camp till the third watch. The following day, everyone who drank the infected water was struck down by the plague. Within a couple of days, smoke no longer rose from the chimneys, nobody walked in the streets, and the air was full of cries and groans. No one could avoid the plague, not even the disciples in the Prime Minister's mansion. Only two men remained unaffected, Neja, who was reincarnated from lotus flowers, and Yang Jin, who was able to Tiho transformations. They were kept busy guarding the city, the palace of King Wu, and the Prime Minister's mansion. "There are only the two of us. What shall we do if Liu Ye comes now with his army?" Neja asked, worried. "Never mind, brother. King Wu is a virtuous ruler, and he will surely be blessed by heaven. Uncle Jiang is fated to suffer in this calamity. I believe that before long someone talented will come to help us out." Yang Jian said assuredly. After scattering the plague pills, Liu Ye bragged to Su Hu. "With my help you will gain the final victory. There's been no need for either swords or arrows. All of West Qi will be wiped out in just 6 days, and you can return home the victors, as I anticipated when I left my island. If they've all been struck down with the disease, there's no guard on the city wall. Let's take the city now," Zheng Lei urged. "That's fine with me." Liu Ye agreed. A delighted Zheng Leng took his men out, ready to storm West Yi City. When he saw Zheng Leng coming, Neja grew worried. He asked Yang Jian, "How can the two of us fight off a whole army, brother?"
"Don't worry. I have a way of scaring him off," he replied.
Yang Jian pulled up two handfuls of soil and grass and threw them up into the air, shouting, "Quick! Hurry up!" In the twinkling of an eye, tall, brave warriors appeared all along the city wall, patrolling to and fro in an impressive show of strength. When Zheng Leng spotted them, he pulled up short and dared not approach the city. He returned to camp and reported to Liu Ye. "The city is strongly guarded. We cannot take it by force." Yang Jian's magic, however, could not last for more than a few hours. They were worrying about what to do next when Neja heard the sound of a crane in the air. It was the yellow dragon immortal. Neja and Yang Jian bowed and greeted him.
"Has your master arrived yet?"
the immortal asked Yang Jian.
"No, not yet, uncle," he replied.
The yellow dragon immortal went to the Prime Minister's mansion to see Jiang Ziya, and then to the palace to see King Wu. He had just returned to the city wall when Jade Tripod arrived on a flash of golden light.
"Why are you so late, brother?"
the yellow dragon immortal asked. "The golden light wasn't as fast as I had expected. Let's act at once. Yang Jian, go straight to the Fire Cloud Cave to see the three holy masters and beg them for the elixirs needed to save the people." Yang Jian left immediately for the Fire Cloud Cave.
Elegant cypresses and ancient pine trees covered the slopes. The scent of fragrant grass filled the air, and cranes chirped in the mist that floated overhead. Green phoenixes flew over lofty mountains, and pleasant pavilions stood half hidden in the purple haze. Dragons lay submerged in winding streams, and tigers lay idly beneath the cliffs. It was the kind of scenery found only in the abode of celestials. Yang Jian dared not enter the cave without permission. He waited a long time before a lad appeared. "Moving forward with a bow," he said. "I'm a disciple of Jade Tripod. By order of my master, I've come to pay my respects to the three holy masters. Would you please report my arrival? Do you know who the three holy men are? How can you refer to them as masters?" the lad asked. "I'm sorry, but I don't know." "Then I won't blame you. They're Emperor Heaven, Emperor Earth, and Emperor Mankind. Thank you for your instruction, brother." When he was admitted, Yang Jian knelt and kowtowed before the three holy men. The one in the middle had two horns on his head. The one on the left had a cape of leaves on his shoulders and tiger skins around his waist. The one on the right was dressed in the robes of an emperor. Yang Jian recognized Emperor Fu Shi in the middle and Emperor Shen Nong on the left. "By order of my master, Jade Tripod, I've come to pay my respects. King Wu and the people of West Qi have all fallen ill with the plague spread by Lu Ye. The victims lie moaning in their beds day and night. King Wu and Jiang Ziya are both at death's door. I beg you to show compassion and save them." Emperor Fu Shi turned to Emperor Shen Nong and said, "The people lived in peace under our rule, never suffering from any calamity. Now the Shang dynasty is in decline, and wars are raging all over the country. The Shang is destined to fall to the Zhou, but Shen Gongbao has disregarded the will of heaven. He has incited wizards to fight West Qi in an effort to help the tyrant. He must be punished. I hope I may trouble you, Imperial Brother, to save the Zhou dynasty and accomplish a deed of great virtue." Emperor Shen Nong immediately replied, "You're right, brother." He got up quickly from his seat, entered his back chamber, and returned with three elixir pills. Handing them to Yang Jian, he said, "Use one for King Wu and his palace, and another for Jiang Ziya and his disciples. The third is to be dissolved in water and spread all over the city." Yang Jian kowtowed his thanks and was on his way out of the cave when the emperor stopped him and led him to the purple mushroom cliff. He searched about for a long time before picking an herb. "Take this herb back to the world of men. It can cure infectious diseases when boiled in water." Yang Jian knelt on the ground and received the herb. "Please tell me its name so that it may remain in the world. It's called sickle-leaved hare's ear." Yang Jian took the pills and the herb and hurried straight back to West Qi, where he reported to Jade Tripod what had transpired. His master immediately took the pills and, following Shen Nong's instructions, cured the whole city of the plague. After 8 days had passed, Lu Ye said assuredly to his disciples, "West Qi city must be dead by now." Su Hu was greatly distressed by the news and secretly left the camp to find out what had happened. To his surprise, he saw the city banners flying as usual and people thronging the streets. He saw both Nijia and Yang Jian in fine health. "What rubbish that sorcerer talks. He's only trying to deceive us. I'll go back and see what he says about this." He returned to the camp and coldly said to Lu Yu, "You told us that the people of West Qi were all dead. Why are there so many soldiers marching about as smartly as ever? What you said is obviously untrue. How can you play such tricks on me?" Lu Ye got up with a start. "That's preposterous. How can it be so? Do you think I would lie? I've just been there and seen it with my own eyes." Lu Ye left the camp and found everything just as Su Hu had described. He made a divination with his fingers and exclaimed, "So Jade Tripod obtained elixirs from the Fire Cloud Cave. He ordered his four disciples and Zheng Lin to attack the city before Jiang Ziya and his generals could fully recover. Su Hu believed that Lu Yu had no chance of winning. He gave Zhou Xin 3,000 soldiers to attack the Cast Gate, Li Qi 3,000 to storm the West Gate, Zhu Tianlin 3,000 to attack the South Gate, and Yang Wenhui another 3,000 to attack the North Gate. Nijia saw the enemy troops approaching from all four directions. He turned hastily to the Yellow Dragon Immortal. "How can the four of us withstand them? What shall we do now?" "Don't worry," the Immortal replied and ordered. "Yang Jian, you meet the enemy at the East Gate. Open the gate wide and let them in. Nijia, you meet them at the West Gate and do the same. Jade Tripod, meet them at the South Gate, and I'll take the North. I'm sure we can deal with them once they're inside the city. If you want to learn what happened in the battle, please read the next chapter."